this notion that the next wave of technology is going to create more equality rather than widen the inequality gap. Are we on the verge of a great democratization of technology?
I think it depends on how it's applied. The reason that it shouldn't. So if you take sort of the banking industry, there's a lot of logical repetitive tasks which are absolutely easy to basically replace with machine learning and replace with robotics. There's incumbent on us to X the general turnover a bank like ourselves has every year to retrain people and upskill people. But actually, in most large companies, certainly in the banking industry, and it would be probably true of most companies in the room, you've probably got a 10% staff turnover every year anyway. So actually, if you look at it in those type of contexts, I don't think any of this results in dramatic headcount reductions as a binary act. It'll happen over time. Now, you could also argue that actually by reducing the sort of cost price of a lot of activities, you will actually have some kind of democratization benefit. So if I take just wealth management, in the banking industry, post the financial crisis, the sale of wealth products has been a highly risky task for a bank because obviously, historically, you relied on individuals to give advice. If that advice turns out to be bad and you can't prove that the person explained 12 years ago exactly what might happen, the bank is likely to be fined. It therefore prices the products to exclude, frankly, most people other than the very, very high net worth. You take a client through a automated questionnaire online and you test the same series of questions about what are your monthly outgoings, do you realize this thing could go down, what would happen if it did, how many dependents have you got, etc., etc. You are actually pointing out to them the risks. You are doing it at a very low cost price. You therefore are making, if you like, investments in places that have self-directed pensions, so the United States, Australia, places like that, where people save and invest for their own sort of future. You're actually, I wouldn't use the word democratizing, but you're actually opening up much better investment processes to them than you could do with very expensive individuals and with the risk of regulatory fines against it. So I wouldn't see it all as a dystopian kind of plus or minus black and white type of equation at all. It's much more complicated and nuanced than that.
And how you deploy the technology, yes. I guess.
Yeah.